Thanks for joining us on the CBN News Channel. I'm Ephraim Graham.
And I'm Charlene Israel. A storm unlike any in decades stalled over major East Coast cities this morning. It's delivering a powerful punch of wet snow, heavy rain, and damaging winds for a second straight day. And many are saying they've had enough of this winter's wild weather.
Heavy snow, flooding rain, and damaging winds. The powerful storm has dumped upwards of 20 inches of snow on sections of northeastern Pennsylvania, New Jersey, and New York. Sections of northern New England weathered heavy rains that pushed some rivers toward flood levels. Winter-weary residents are ready for it to end.
Some winters are bad, some winters are good. This is a bad one.
I am totally done with the snow. I'm ready for spring.
Three deaths have been blamed on the storm, including a man in New York's Central Park, killed by a falling snow-laden branch. Airlines are canceling hundreds of flights, and more than 100,000 homes are still without power across the region. That's due to toppled trees and near blizzard conditions.
It'll get better. Can't get much worse, right?
More than 30 inches of snow has fallen in New York City. That's 12 inches above normal. Philadelphia is expecting another 8 inches on top of the record 73 inches that have already fallen this year.
Forecasters say the storm is expected to let up this weekend.
The day-long health care summit is now over, but some aren't sure if it made any difference. There are now reports President Obama wants health care reform legislation passed by mid-March. And if that does not happen, he may ask Congress to temporarily set it aside.
I hope that this isn't political fear.
We believe we have a better idea, reducing health care costs. And start over, and let's go step by step toward that goal.
Every so often we have a pretty good conversation trying to get on some specifics, and then we go back to, you know, the standard talking points the Democrats and Republicans have had for the last year.
Frankly, I was discouraged by the outcome. I do not believe there will be any Republican support for this 2,700-page bill that the American people are so overwhelmingly opposed to.
CBN White House correspondent David Brody tells us what to expect next in the battle over health care reform.
Well, now that this health care reform summit is over, there are a couple of key questions going forward. First of all, what is the polling going to look like here? In other words, right now, what you have is Republicans, but mostly Democrats, really wondering how the public viewed this health care reform summit. In essence, they're waiting for the polling to come out. I mean, the bottom line is this. If these Democrats feel like there has been a tide switch, in other words, if they believe that the polls are looking good now in their favor, that this health care reform summit actually did something in a positive way to get more people on board with health care reform, then indeed you may see these reconciliation plans that we're hearing so much about and this bill itself go forward. If, on the other hand, those poll numbers don't look good, then you're going to have a lot of these Democrats start to back away. So we're going to wait and watch on that. One of the other interesting parts of this health care reform summit is simply the fact that the Republicans were able to stand toe-to-toe with President Obama. No prompter in the room for the president. The president giving just as well as he received. In essence, there was an equal playing field here, and that was a positive for Republicans. One other issue, and it came up quite a bit during the health care reform summit, and that is simply this idea of reconciliation, budget reconciliation to be exact. In other words, the Democrats only need 51 votes if they really want to push the envelope and pass some of this health care reform. Now, having said that, they can't get the whole bill through budget reconciliation, but they can pass many key parts that relate to revenue. And clearly, the Democrats said during that budget or that health care reform summit that they look to indeed, they may indeed try this budget reconciliation move if Republicans are not going to play fair, according to the Democrats. So all in all, I mean, each side pretty much got what they wanted out of it, and we'll see how it goes forward. David Brody, CBN News, Washington.
David, thank you. While Democrats and Republicans debated the health care overhaul inside the Blair House, protesters on both sides of the issue had their own debate outside. Paul Strand has that now from Washington.
Conservatives and liberals were both out protesting, but ironically, there was agreement between the two sides. They agreed that the current health care proposal isn't good. The liberals want it to go further and include a public option. The conservatives want to scrap the current plan and start over.
I believe they should start from scratch and not have legislation that is based on deals done in secret that are not only not constitutional, but they're not moral.
I don't think it's the will of the American people. And I think that we can reform health care, make it cheaper, make it more accessible to everyone without the government trying to take over.
Some protesters were there for the pro-life cause. Tony Perkins of the Family Research Council explains why they're afraid of the Senate's version of a reform bill.
We, as Christians, would be forced with our tax dollars to subsidize and underwrite abortion, a massive expansion of abortion in this country.
Paul Strand, CBN News, Washington.
Congress's disapproval rating has reached its highest level ever in a new Rasmussen poll. 71% of voters now say the House and Senate are doing a poor job, and only 10% say Congress is doing a good or excellent job. An earlier poll found that 63% of voters said it would be better for the country if most incumbents were defeated this November.
The House Ethics Committee says New York Congressman Charles Rangel violated House rules by accepting money for trips. A new report says Rangel broke the rules when he took corporate money to pay for trips to the Caribbean. The committee said Rangel might not have known about the source of the funds, but his staff did. Rangel is chairman of the powerful Ways and Means Committee. The case raises doubts about his chances for re-election come this fall.
A bill that extends key provisions of the Patriot Act is on its way to President Obama's desk. It includes phone surveillance and seizure provisions that some Democrats say violate privacy. They were set to expire on Sunday. Senate Democrats had tried to add new privacy protections to the act, but couldn't get past a Republican filibuster.
The Afghan government is now officially in control of the city of Marja, the Taliban's southern stronghold. The government has appointed a new leader for the town. Residents are starting to return to homes and shops as they open back up. A sign of the largest Afghan offensive since 2001 has been a success.
The U.S. Homeland Security Secretary is publicly admitting something no other Obama administration official has. In a hearing this week, Janet Napolitano said violent Islamic terrorism was part and parcel of the Fort Hood killings. Fox News reports it's the first time the administration has publicly called Army Major Nidal Hassan's attacks terrorism.
A Rhode Island school district has fired every single teacher at one of its underperforming high schools. It is the largest example of the get tough approach on schools that are falling behind. But as Lori Johnson reports, some say teachers' unions could be to blame for these pink slips.
Maria Coletta, Andrea Analdo, Stephanie Zuber.
It read like a roll call. One by one, teachers at Central Falls High School were called out and fired. 74 teachers in all.
I've been in Central Falls for 28 years, and I have done nothing to deserve to be fired. Absolutely nothing.
The high school is one of the lowest performing in the state. Only 48% of the students graduate. The government is demanding the school make changes or close down. So district officials proposed a transformation plan. It included 25-minute longer days and requiring teachers to tutor after school. The teachers' union rejected that proposal, saying teachers needed to be paid more for the overtime, $90 an hour. The average teacher's salary at the school is over $60,000 a year. Negotiations between the union and the district broke down, leaving them with no choice but to fire the teachers. Superintendent Dr. Francis Gallo tells CBN News most of the teachers agreed with the changes but lost their jobs because the union threw them under the bus.
I expected the teachers to stand up and speak to the union and say these are not outlandish requests and we want them. I met with teachers, anybody who wanted to meet. I met openly with them and individually no one objected.
And left confused and disturbed in this tangled mess of bureaucracy, the students.
It's not motivating me to come to school anymore. It's not going to change any student's mind.
Not once did the union put the children first in their thinking or bring them to the table and bring their needs with them. It's all about adult entitlement, and that's a very difficult situation.
The Obama administration supports the firings and continues to insist every state fix its lowest performing schools.
Enough is enough. We can't continue to wait. Our children have one chance to get a quality education.
The teachers union is pursuing all legal options to fight the firings. They're warning states across the country that if this can happen in Rhode Island, it can happen anywhere.
It's a pretty scary thing when the leaders of our children, the teachers, the role models in their lives are not thinking for themselves and are led around by union leadership.
The terminations will go into effect at the end of the school year. All teachers will be allowed to reapply for their jobs.
Evangelist Benny Hinn has issued a statement about his wife's recent divorce announcement. Hinn posted a 3-page letter on his website. It says that his wife, Suzanne, has no biblical grounds for divorce and that there was no immorality involved by either of them. It goes on to say that the two were totally committed to each other for 30 years of marriage and that neither he nor his 4 children know why Suzanne filed for divorce. The evangelist is asking supporters for prayers for his family's healing and adds that any pending divorce will not stop him from fulfilling his call to ministry.
Coming up, from the Winter Olympics, they call him the Pin Man, and he's telling people about a higher prize.
Are the most powerful songs of our time.
Now is the time to worship.
And now, for the first time, the biggest praise and worship songs are together.
How great is our God.
Presenting Songs for Worship 50. 50 songs in one specially priced collection.
Holy is the Lord God.
You'll hear 50 beautiful songs of hope.
I'm coming back to the heart of worship, and it's
50 powerful songs of faith.
Amazing love, how can it be?
Get Songs for Worship 50 on 3 CDs for only
$24.99. Here I am for worship. Here I am.
But wait. Order in the next 10 minutes with your credit card, and we'll take $15 off. That's right. You get 50 praise and worship songs for just
$9.99.
Then preview other great praise and worship collections. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
So call now and get Songs for Worship 50. 50 beautiful songs on 3 CDs for just
$9.99.
Call 1-800-435-3414 to order Songs for Worship 50 on 3 CDs for $9.99 plus shipping and handling when you use your credit card. Call now or order online at timelife.com/songsforworship50.
The U.S. picked up a handful of medals at Thursday's Winter Olympic Games, but not the one most Americans were hoping to win. The U.S. lost the gold medal to Canada in women's hockey and settled for the silver. 17-year-old U.S. champ Rachel Flatt finished with a personal best in ladies' figure skating, but the gold medal went to South Korea. Americans still lead the medal count right now with 32. Today, the undefeated Team USA takes on Finland in men's hockey. This is the final weekend for the 2010 Olympic Games. Closing ceremonies will take place Sunday evening. The next Winter Olympics will be held in Sochi, Russia in 2014.
Well, hundreds of Christian ministers are in Vancouver for the Olympics. They see it as a great opportunity to share their message with the thousands of spectators who come from all over the world to watch the games.
This next story comes to us from our friends at the Southern Baptist Convention's North American Mission Board. It's about one evangelist they call the Pin Man. Take a look.
And I think I like this one.
We're with More Than Gold, and this is the pin that we have for the Olympics, and it's a storytelling pin.
All right.
I'm Sid Hopkins. They call me the pin man. Here's a guy that's got some pins on. Let's see if we can catch him. And the goal is that a relationship with Jesus is more precious than gold, even a gold medal at the Olympics. Well, I've got pins from all over from quite a number of Olympics. That's a little pin we used in Greece. You have some pins you want to trade? This is my sixth Olympic. I've got probably 150 pins on me, and then I probably got several thousand pins that I've collected.
You're wonderful.
If that's going to be for your dad who had a stroke, then you take it, okay? So I can trade with anybody just about anything they want and have a good time trading with them, and then being able to share with them the more than gold pin and tell the story of that pin as well. And then the red represents the blood of Jesus Christ that died to pay the penalty for our sin. People were coming up to me wanting to have their picture made with me, wanting to be able to just trade a pin with a pin man. And so most of the time they would come up in groups of two, three, or four as a family. So I'd get to share the gospel with two or three or four people at a time. But this tells the story of how to have a relationship with God. And so it's an evangelistic outreach. But often there are people on the run going to an event or going somewhere, and they'll give you 2 or 3 minutes. And when we have a personal relationship with Jesus, when we die, we go to heaven. So the blue represents heaven. But whether it's hospitality here or whether it's sharing a pen, you're planting a lot of seeds. And they're going all over the world as people go back to their home country.
The next station is Columbus.
And I'm going to mark the Gospel of John here for you, okay?
Thank you very much.
All right. God bless you here. All right. So they're excited when you give them a pen or share with them a scripture or anything. They really treasure it, and they thank you and thank you and thank you, and they get off the bus and wave at you.
Wow.
Isn't that great? And when we believe and trust in Jesus, he gives us new life. So the green represents the new life that we have in Christ. You read that and think and pray about it, okay?
Oh, thank you very
okay.
much.
Okay, all right.
Thank you.
God bless.
A true Olympic winner indeed. Kentucky Senate has approved a measure allowing Bible classes in public schools. The bill allows schools to offer courses in the Bible as electives, meaning no student will be required to take them. The proposal overwhelmingly cleared the Senate by a vote of 37-1 and will now be taken up by the House. The only no vote was cast by a Democrat who questioned the constitutionality of teaching the Bible in public schools.
Up next, the plantation worker who got a president's attention. Robert Small's amazing journey from slave to Civil War hero to statesman.
Israel, the land where God came to mankind. Imagine to be in the place where our Lord lived, to stand where he performed his miracles, to see where he taught the multitudes. The pages of the Bible come alive in the land filled with God's promises. Don't miss this experience of a lifetime. Visit Israel. You'll never be the same.
Call today.
Each week, thousands of concerned parents and grandparents start Globe Young American plans for their children and grandchildren. The Young American Plan is a simple, affordable way to secure valuable life insurance protection. Starting a Young American Plan today guarantees the future insurability of your loved ones. Once issued, the Young American Plan can never be canceled. For just $1, you can start a Young American Plan and feel safe knowing you've provided your child or grandchild with a lifetime of protection. The regular premium you establish now is guaranteed to never increase. And the Young American Plan builds cash value that can be used in the future. Since 1964, millions of concerned parents and grandparents have started Globe Young American Plans for their children and grandchildren. Call Globe today.
Call right now for complete information about the Globe Young American Plan. Call Globe today at 1-800-457-4154.
Israel, the land where God came to mankind. Imagine to be in the place where our Lord lived, to stand where he performed his miracles, to see where he taught the multitudes. The pages of the Bible come alive in the land filled with God's promises. Don't miss this experience of a lifetime. Visit Israel. You'll never be the same.
Call today.
As we honor Black History this month, we take a look at one man's remarkable story. Robert Smalls was born a slave but went on to become a war hero after leading a daring mission in the Civil War.
That's right. Smalls was honored by President Lincoln and became the Navy's first Black captain. After the war, he even went on to serve in Congress. Here's our look at the amazing life of Robert Smalls.
Nestled among the natural and historic beauty of South Carolina's low country lies the story of an unlikely hero.
We're going to lay down our life for the Lord.
Robert Smalls was born a slave in Beaufort in 1839.
For the Lord.
His mother, Lydia, was a household servant and a privileged servant.
His mother was a woman of deep faith, and she raised him until he turned 12. All that time she was teaching him, but she also took him with her to church.
Lydia taught her son about Jesus, that God created men to be equal, and slaves were supposed to be free. He learned the harsh realities of slavery firsthand when his mother arranged for him to go to the fields.
She took him to see the disciplining of slaves, which was about two blocks from where we're standing at the arsenal.
One time she took him to see a young woman being whipped. He could see her face of this young lady, and he saw that this was a young woman that he knew. And his mother said he cried all the way home.
At the age of 12, Smalls was leased out by his master to work as a lamplighter and waiter in Charleston. His owner only let him keep one of the $15 he earned each month. Smalls eventually married Hannah Jones, who was 14 years his senior.
And he saved money not to buy his own freedom, but to buy his wife's freedom. There's a love story for you.
He also pursued his faith in Charleston.
He went to different churches. He went to white churches with his girlfriend, Hannah, and they sat in the gallery, and he went to Black churches.
Charleston is also where he began working on the Confederate steamship, the Planter.
He understood the waterways, he knew the passages, he could read charts, and through his experience as a pilot, he comes to be very, very astute about the waters and how to operate small vessels.
The white officers of the ship did not spend the night aboard their vessel. Smalls used that opportunity to plan an escape with his family and other slaves aboard the ship. Before dawn on May 13, 1862, Smalls and the other 12 slaves began their mission. A mission Smalls began with a quick but fervent prayer.
Oh Lord, be with us on this faithful journey.
Smalls is dressed in the captain's coat, wearing the captain's straw hat. He knows all the proper signals. He gives the signals as they go past the various fortifications.
Smalls made it safely to the mouth of the Charleston Harbor. Fearing a Confederate soldier would challenge him at Fort Sumter, he prayed again.
Oh Lord, we entrust ourselves into thy hands. Like thou didst for the Israelites in Egypt, please stand over us and guide us to our promised land of freedom.
God answered his prayer, and Small steered his ship out to sea. There he approached the Union ship, the Onward, and raised a white flag, just as Union soldiers were about to fire on him. After the daring escape, the Union press hailed him a hero. By capturing a Confederate ship, Smalls and his crew won a large sum of money. He was also honored by President Abraham Lincoln and later became the first African-American captain in the Navy.
Smalls' story doesn't end here. He had a long career in politics, education, and business. He was elected to the South Carolina House of Representatives and Senate and later served 12 years in the U.S. Congress.
Driven by his faith to invest in the lives of others, Smalls also became a champion of public education and giving Black men the right to vote. As a businessman, he purchased several buildings in Beaufort, one with a story which clearly showed his Christ-like attitude.
He bought the house of his former owner where he was raised and lived in it for the rest of his life. One of the most interesting episodes in that house was when Mrs. McKee, who was the former owner of the house, was elderly, somewhat impoverished, and apparently a little addled in the head, returned to her home to stay. And Robert Smalls owned the house and his family was living there. And rather than turn her away, Robert Smalls brought her into the house, put her up in the bedroom that had been her bedroom before the Civil War, and served her.
Smalls died in 1915 at the age of 76.
Religion was a part of his life. It wasn't that he spoke about it all the time, but the way he acted and the things he did was reflective of that.
Our life for the Lord.
What a godly man.
Mm-hmm. It's an example that true freedom comes from Christ Jesus.
Exactly.
Indeed. Stay with us. We're coming right back.
Introducing Easy Combs, the easy new way to create dazzling new do's. Simply slide in one end, stretch it around your hair, and slide in on the other side for an updo that's brand new. Or fluff it out for a fountain effect. Look again. The bungee band stretch and release for a relaxed custom fit every time. Liven up a ponytail or create this amazing butterfly twist. It's great for short hair and ideal for the office. It's perfect for any formal occasion. Ouch, claw clips hurt. But Easy Combs are soft and comfortable, so easy to use, kids love them too. Now get Easy Combs in caramel bronze for only $10. Call now and get one in dazzling silver. As a special bonus, get our Bermuda Black plus a styling DVD. Just pay separate shipping and handling. With the step-by-step DVD, Easy Combs are a cinch. You get caramel, silver, and black plus the style guide and DVD, a $60 value, all for only $10.
Call 1-800-520-1486. You'll get the bonus Easy Combs as advertised when you call 1-800-520-1486.
Love to shop for shoes, but there's no place to store them? You're always running out of room to store more. Introducing Shoes Under, the easy solution to organize and protect your shoes. The clear zipper cover locks out dust and moisture. Now you just slide and store. It's that easy. With two handles, you can easily store your shoes here, under there, almost everywhere, and turn an empty space into a super storage place. Other shoe organizers can cost a fortune, but through this exclusive television offer, you can get the 12-compartment Shoes Under for only $19.99. Call now and we'll cut that price in half. That's right, for only $10. And as a bonus, we'll double the offer and give you a second Shoes Under that's enough space for 48 shoes. Just pay separate shipping and handling. Call now and get two Shoes Under for only $10.
Call 1-800-943-1652. You'll get a second one free, so call 1-800-943-1652. That's 1-800-943-1652. Call now.
Welcome back. Well, it is the Chinese version of a winter wonderland. 5.5 million cubic feet of ice has been used to transform the city of Harbin into a polar paradise. The impressive display includes Egyptian sphinxes, terracotta warriors, and even a replica of the Great Wall. More than 10,000 laborers worked around the clock for 3 weeks to complete the exhibit. It's a tradition that's been going on for 25 years.
It's indescribable, right? You know, just like most of China is indescribable because it's so large and everything's on such a mass scale.
The festival is one of the largest of its kind in the world, and despite the below freezing temperatures, it attracts nearly 10,000 visitors a day.
And finally today, he is 82 years young and still going strong. Nothing seems to keep Speedy Shepherd from playing his violin. The Salisbury, North Carolina man has been fiddling since he was a small boy. Speedy never learned to read music, but his father taught him how to play. He says the highlight of his career was playing in the band with a young Willie Nelson. There you go.
Well, that's all for this hour of the CBN News Channel. You can find information on all the stories you've seen here at CBNNews.com.
Have a wonderful weekend.
Yeah, buddy.
How many nickels are in a dollar?
There are 20 nickels in a dollar.
How do birds fly? Does milk really make my bones stronger?
Yeah.
Daddy, when we die, will we go to heaven?
Do you have the answer to life's biggest question? Call the 700 Club. We'll help you find answers to the important questions life brings your way.
Fresh, wholesome juice. There's nothing like it. But until now, you had to stress and strain and make a huge mess to get just a little bit of juice. But not anymore, thanks to the Jack LaLanne Power Juicer. You can drop in whole vegetables, whole fruits, apples, oranges, celery, cucumbers with no chopping, no slicing, no struggling. And thanks to the Power Juicer's revolutionary patented extraction technology, you can get up to 30% more juice than those other juicers. Doctors recommend we get 5 to 9 servings of fruits and vegetables every day. With the Power Juicer, you'll be drinking your recommended daily allowance allowance in just seconds. And the pulp from the extra large pulp catcher can be used to make pasta sauces, healthy desserts, and much more. The power juicer is dishwasher safe, so cleanup's a breeze, and the powerful motor is guaranteed for life. Order the Jack LaLanne power juicer now for just two easy payments of $49.90. And as part of this special TV offer, we'll also send you this amazing recipe guide filled with over 60 of Jack's favorite recipes. Try the Jack LaLanne power juicer in your home risk-free for 30 days. If you're not completely satisfied, send it back for a full refund of the purchase price, no questions asked. Call now.